Welcome to Activ Living Podcast by Aditya Birla Health Insurance. It's all about healthy living. Get your daily dose of health and fitness, physical and mental, with me, Dr. Aditi Govitrikar, your wellness and lifestyle coach. Today, I'm going to talk about sleeping well. Did you know that Indians are second most sleep deprived in the world? Sleep is a critical aspect of our life and it affects our overall health. The body rhythm follows the sun to follow a routine known as circadian rhythm, which keeps us awake during the day and asleep at night. On an average, an adult sleeps anywhere from 4 hours to 12 hours. Many people have complained of lockdown sleep deprivation or COVIDsomnia. Why, you ask? That's because our brain is perceiving the pandemic as a looming threat, a constant danger that will come and get us. And when we are stressed or scared, we can't fall asleep. The stresses and worries regarding life security, job security, lack of social life, limited mobility, excessive screen time, amongst other things, just keep rising, leading to poor sleep quality and excessive daytime sleepiness. Besides, working from home and eating meals at an erratic hour further confuses our body and messes up the circadian rhythm. If the difference in sleep timing and duration during work days and days off becomes too large, it leads to a social jet lag or sleep debt, which is extremely difficult to cover. Do any of these symptoms apply to you? If you show either signs of fatigue, poor attention span, or inability to concentrate, an urge to take naps during the day, headaches, or a heaviness of the head, general body aches, irritability, mood swings, poor work performance, overeating, or undereating, you may be affected by COVIDsomnia. The good news is that it can be worked on. Remember, sleeping well is the key to maintain healthy physical and mental mindset. So make up your mind that from tonight, you will take steps to ensure better sleep. What can you do to sleep better? Avoid exposure to mobile phones, laptop or television or any gadget for that matter, at least 2 hours before your bedtime. The blue light emanating prevents you from falling asleep. Avoid keeping your mobile phone next to your head. Keep it at least 2 arms length away from the bed. Chamomile tea, ambient lighting, and calming music should be used to create a relaxing atmosphere. Avoid coffee after 5 p.m. and do not sleep immediately after having dinner. There should be a gap of at least 2 hours. Meditate for 10 minutes before you sleep. You could also listen to some meditative music to relax. Allocate some time during the day to process your worries and thoughts. You can use a journal to jot down all those worries and thoughts. Stick to routines as much as possible. Don't work from your bed or bedroom. Keep your bedroom only for relaxing and sleeping. Be as active as possible and tire your body with exercises and physical activities. Get at least 10 minutes of sunlight. Go to your terrace or garden or just your building compound. Stay away from news in the first 2 hours of the day or 2 hours before you retire, and include things that give you joy in your daily routine, such as hobbies or gardening or reading. Avoid binge watching of a series. We tend to sit for a long time and ek aur episode se kuch nahi hoga. This thought keeps you watching over time, thereby straining your eyes, plus the blue light from the screen will take away from the sleep. Ensure social interaction with your family and loved ones. Give your eyes a break and exercise them. You can do this by looking away from the screen after every 20 minutes. Look at the sky or greenery if you have it around, or just close your eyes for 2 minutes. That will help your eyes relax and your brain will also be relaxed.
This is Dr. Aditi Govitrikar signing off. Hope you are now closer to active living. Subscribe or follow Activ Living Podcast by Aditya Birla Health Insurance for more doses of health and fitness, mental and physical.